Her eyes are blue, her hair was long, at 64, she was born in Baton Rouge. Her very song was in my life. I memorized her every move. I knew her books, her car, her clothes. But I paid no attention to her.
That's Cy Holden's 1995 mega country hit, What Mattered Most. The debut single from, at the time, an almost unknown singer was a chart-topping sensation. As it turns out, though, this ballad about love lost and a late epiphany, as well as all the success that came with it, was essentially based on a lie. Almost a quarter of a century later, and Herndon is setting the record straight, releasing a new version. Try and spot the difference.
His eyes are blue, his hair was long, at 64, he was born. Favorite song was in my life. I memorized his every move. I knew his books, his car, his clothes. But I paid no attention to what mattered most.
There is nothing quite like the power of a pronoun, and by changing she to he, Herndon is not only righting a wrong, but clearly revealing much about who he is and who he was. 24 years ago, the man himself, Ty Herndon, is with us. So welcome. Thanks for coming in. Did you recognize that young guy there, that young fella singing that song? Did you?
There is such a 25 years of love,
yeah,
for that young man from the beginning to now. But he loves himself so much more now. I was just sitting here thinking, though, looking at that, because it's been a minute since I've seen the new version.
Yeah.
And I know so many kids have seen that now, because I go out and speak to so many kids around the world, and it's amazing to hear them talk to me now.
That was 33-year-old Ty Herndon, and I think what a lot of people don't realize about this song is just how big it was at the time, what a huge success it was. I mean, here's a part of a report from the Dallas Morning News, April 1995. His first single, What Mattered Most, continues to explode all over the radio and the national country charts. In its first week, the song received 133 ads, meaning 133 radio stations across the nation played the tune out of the box. His debut album, also titled What Mattered Most, hit stores Tuesday with advance orders, a whopping 200,000 copies. Yeah, and for the most part, at that time, you know, everyone was thinking this is a love song in the traditional sense. You know, everyone that is, except for you,
right,
and presumably your partner of what at that time 14 years, relationship.
Yeah,
so, what did he think of the new version? Have you been in touch with the person who, you know, was sort of the focus of the song?
He just said, "Congratulations, man! Congratulations on your 100% authenticity and being able to tell your story the way you've always wanted to tell it." And congratulations on the minds and hearts you're going to change.
How did you justify it?
There was no way I could. Now, I knew that I was going to be out there singing to millions of people, and this was an amazing song.
Yeah.
So we fight for amazing songs. We do it today.
Yeah.
And the songwriter was the song. It was tailor-made for me, and it's such a beautiful production of it, and I was excited to have it.
Right.
And, you know, I'd been in this business a long time. I won Texas Entertainer of the Year, which finally got me to Nashville.
Right.
And they gave me that song, and I was so happy to get it.
Your Mayor Pete Buttigieg is the first openly gay candidate for president. He gave a very emotional speech earlier this year where he sort of addressed the issues, you know, of being gay and coming out, and he took it head on. And he said a couple of really, you know, pertinent or very sort of moving things during this speech. I want you to listen to part of that speech. Here he is.
Absolutely.
If you had offered me a pill to make me straight, I would have swallowed it before you had time to get me a sip of water. It was a hard thing to think about now. It's hard to face the truth that there were times in my life when if you had shown me exactly what it was inside me that made me gay, I would have cut it out with a knife.
You know, I see you nodding along. Mm-hmm. So how can you obviously relate? You can relate to that, especially as a much younger man.
It's hard to see that and talk about it because I feel the same way. You know, there were times I did not want to live.
Yeah.
You know, I wanted the same knife. I wanted to cut it out. I would have taken, you know, I said this to me. It's interesting that I saw this when it was on. I said, oh, my gosh, we wanted the same pill.
Yeah.
You know, I wouldn't have hesitated to take it. But my journey today, that was not my story. This is my story.
Yeah.
And the fact that I get to be out there and sing to millions of people and create music and do what I need to do. And to know that 11-year-old kid sitting out there at home watching TV and watching YouTube, who wants to come to Nashville and be an entertainer, sees my face and knows that you can do this and you're not alone.
times have definitely very much changed now from 1995. You came out in 2014.
Yeah.
And once you come out, you never stop coming out. You have to keep coming out over and over and over again, right?
Never it's ends. Very true.
Yeah. But you've made this conscious decision since going public that you will support teenage gay kids and their parents and their families.
Even younger.
You sort of want to give them the sort of the structure and the environment and a sort of a safety
community.
Environment and,
yes.
and the support that I guess you didn't have.
Exactly. If I would have had the community that these kids are putting together today, kids are coming out as young as 10 years old, and some of them know exactly who they are, and others are confused. But to put a community together of these kids that are going through the same thing, I just did a whole brand new video with a group of kids in Nashville called the Rainbow Squad.
Right.
And they're amazing. And just to watch them, how happy they are, and just with this community, they get together every 2 weeks from all around Nashville. And I wanted to show the world what a happy kid looks like. And what you've been out there searching for forever
is in your hands. I think Nashville has changed so much. Oh my gosh, the community is so wonderful.
It's filled with all kind of folks from all walks of life, and we're really feeling the pressure to grow.
Right.
Yeah, and I'm happy to be one of those people pushing that. And there, we have a lot of us that are in Nashville, from Shelly Wright, Shane McAnally, so many wonderful people that are out and pushing.
You have a new album coming out on Friday.
I do.
Got it covered. There's a lot going on. It has a new updated version of What Mattered.
What Mattered Most, yes.
Yeah, and there's also another track there in particular which I want to reference. It's So Small, originally Carrie Underwood here.
Yes.
Here's a clip. When you figure out love is all that matters after all, it sure makes everything else.
Oh, it sure makes everything else seem so small.
Lots of kids, lots of rainbow flags. Oh, and who's this guy at the end? What's going on here?
Kind of handsome, isn't he?
Yeah.
So, now you've made me cry. Congratulations.
Oh, thank you very much. We got that.
I got the tears rolling, you guys. Oh my gosh, you know that. Thank you, Carrie, for writing and recording such an awesome song. But I had that. I'll make a long story really short. I had gotten back to Nashville and just kind of milling around trying to do music, and I just made the decision there wasn't a place for me anymore.
Right.
And I actually signed up for a very expensive real estate class.
You're going to be a real estate agent.
I was going to be a real estate agent.
Right.
I'm sitting in my truck, you know, on the Saturday morning, and I heard this song for the first time. You know, and I'm a firm believer that songs are put out there in the universe for people to hear exactly at the right time in their life. And I live by that rule. And so, of course, it happened to me. And
yeah.
It was just, I've not heard anything like this on the radio in a long time. It was spiritual. It was powerful. And it was life-changing for me. And I didn't take the class. I turned around and I got my butt busy getting back in the music business. And I wanted to do music like that, music that mattered, music that changed hearts and minds, and music that just hit people in the face. So that's what I've been trying to do. I hope I did it on this new record.
Thank you for sharing your story. It's been
Absolutely.
A great story to hear. So thank you for coming
friend.
In.
Thank you.
And also thank you to you and Eric Hallbig for recording the new version of What Mattered, Mattered Most. And we're going to play some of that right now as we head into a short break. World Sport is next. I'm John Borch. We'll see you then.
Very nice. I thought I knew the boy so well. If he was sad, I could not tell. I missed the point, and I missed the signs. If he's gone, the fault is mine. And I know, a whole lot of little things. Even though I could list them one by one, he would still be gone.